Most people with high blood pressure have no symptoms whatsoever, so we describe it as being asymptomatic, which is why it's important that blood pressure is actually checked and measured. So the main risk related to high blood pressure, as I said, it's a condition, so in itself doesn't have much in the way of symptoms, but what we recognise is that it's a significant factor in the development of furring of the arteries, both those around the heart, what we call the coronary arteries, and those leading up to the brain, the carotid arteries, and also into the brain substance themselves, the cerebral arteries. And the high blood pressure encourages the development of stiffening, and if that stiffening gets to a point where the blood vessel, particularly in the brain, gets shrunken, then that can lead to stroke. And so we recognise that high blood pressure is one of the primary causes of stroke. The other thing that we find is if one develops furring due to cholesterol being pushed into the arteries, then one can start to get narrowings, which can give rise to angina. So that's chest pain due to reduced blood supply to the heart muscle. And also we find that if one gets furring in the neck arteries, the carotid arteries, again with a combination of cholesterol deposits, those areas can start to fracture, lead to formation of clots, which then roll off and travel up to the brain and can impact in the brain and cause strokes.